about that in a moment, but we want to touch on a couple of announcements. I was asked to make this announcement to SPPRC committee. You know who you are. That would be this year's group, not the folks that are beginning their term in January. Stephanie Beaver would like to meet with you outside the narthex after the service, just briefly today in the narthex. So that would be great if you can do that. Also, you all know that our dear Kaylee Jo had her surgery this past week. And mom and dad came in, or dad came in this morning because mom's been staying in the hospital. Angie's been in the hospital every day, just staying there 24/7. And was told this morning that her one lung, she had been taken off the respirator after surgery the day after, I believe it was. But now she's back on the respirator.
She's on BiPAP.
Pardon?
She's on BiPAP.
Oh, she's on BiPAP.
Yeah.
Okay, whatever that is.
It's a mask that pours air into it.
Okay, so it's not a respirator, but it's helping her breathe.
Right.
Okay. One lung collapsed, partially collapsed, fluid built up in the other lung. So,
not in, around
it. Okay. You should just come up here to help me out. I just got this in 30 seconds as Brad was coming in this morning. The point is, we need prayers for Kaylee Jo and for the family. And I know there's lots of other prayer concerns out there. But I know I've been asked through this week, as I've seen people since the surgery, how's Kaylee Jo doing? And she was coming along very well, and actually as of yesterday morning yet, seemed to be some improvement. But wanted to ask you especially to pray for Kaylee Jo Weaver today and throughout the week and on. Want to just lift up those names of those folks as we do each week who are going to be celebrating birthdays and anniversaries. And I know we've got some visitors with us today, not just the folks up here, but some others that have come as well. But I want to just acknowledge that Zach and Kara Hackenberg are celebrating their anniversary this week. And Joyce and Scott back in the booth, the Dreeses, are celebrating their anniversary as well. Birthday celebrations include Brad Brouse and Ron Mall and Darla Hartman and Butch Coons. Is Butch back there somewhere? Also Milford Smith, and remember Christine Walter, who's at Penn, I still call it Penn Lutheran, the manor at Penn Village. Christine is celebrating a birthday that should be around 94 or 95, somewhere in that vicinity. Pardon?
96.
Make it 96, okay. 96 for Christine. And Darlene Graybill is also celebrating a birthday this week. Any other birthdays? Anybody other anniversaries? And how about up here? Anybody having a birthday this week? No? Okay. Well, we wish you all that are celebrating anniversaries. I pray it's a very special day for you and for those of you with birthdays as well. You'll see some notes in the bulletin. We got a very short notice on asking for help to pack Thanksgiving baskets. That's the community outreach we do as the Middleburg Ministerium every year. So it's in your bulletin today for you. But if anyone can go to the Emmanuel Lutheran Church in Middleburg, right in town, the brick church in town, on Tuesday at 5:30, you can help pack Thanksgiving baskets for folks who could use a Thanksgiving basket this year with all the economic woes that many families are experiencing. So if you can help out with that effort, show up at the Emmanuel Lutheran Church at 5:30 this Tuesday evening. Also, don't forget the Christmas program practice. There'll be one this evening. And some of the other announcements in the bulletin you can just check out for yourself. Our Christmas party is coming up very soon, our church Christmas party. Sandy Spots reminded me this morning that the Rocket Club for Children, their Christmas party will coincide with the church Christmas party. So as soon as we're done eating, Sandy and all the Rocket Club kids will go and do their own thing. And guess what we're going to do? We're going to come up to the sanctuary because a young man from the Montoursville area by the name of Nick Biddle will be here to do a Christmas concert for us after our Christmas party. So we'll join together in the fellowship hall at 6 o'clock. That was previously 6:30. So we've moved it up a half an hour so we can get everything in and then be up to the sanctuary here by 7:30 to enjoy Nick Biddle and his ministry. Any other announcements that need to be made? Please check, keep abreast of those things that are in your bulletin for this coming week. And we, of course, pray that you have an awesome Thanksgiving.
Family, if you're traveling, we pray traveling mercies on you. But what we are going to do right now is give you an opportunity before we begin to share the peace of Christ with one another. Why don't you wish your neighbor a happy Thanksgiving? Let them know you're glad they're here this morning. Let's stand and do that before we begin.
rejoice in your great gift to us.
You've given us victory, Lord. You brought healing into our lives, joy into our lives, purpose into our lives. And we give you thanks. It is so appropriate, O God, not to set a day aside we call Thanksgiving, but to say, to set our lives aside, lives that would say, thank you, Lord, for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for loving us so much, so greatly, so wonderfully. And may we, Lord, be faithful to you as you've been so faithful to us. Use us, Lord. Bless our lives, our ministry. Thank you for this wonderful ministry from Penn Lutheran with us today, Lord. Just pray your blessing on each and every person who is a part of the ministry, a part of the school, a part of their outreach. Use them, Lord, to bring glory to yourself and victory to so many lives. For we ask it in the name of your Son, him who is lifted up, he who has been raised. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody says,
Amen.
Please be seated. It is my great pleasure to introduce to you right now, and I'm sure you'll give them a good old-fashioned, not just Snyder County, but Hummel welcome, Penn View Bible Institute Symphonic Ensemble. We welcome them.
Thank you.
of God as well this morning. Hasn't he been faithful to you time and time and time again? There's an old bluegrass song that my father used to make me listen to every once in a while. And I say make because I can't stand the bluegrass. But it was just constantly playing in our home as growing up because that's what my dad liked to listen to. But there's some good words to some of those old country songs. And one of them was this. If all I had was taken away, I guess I'd still have to say that God has been good to me. And I guess that's where I'm at this morning. I love him, and I'm so grateful for the privilege of giving my life to him and his service. And this morning, as you hear the beautiful music, there are going to be songs that you recognize right away, some that maybe you're not as familiar with. We're going to have some singing like you just heard off and on throughout the program this morning. But more than anything, our desire is that the presence of the Lord would bear on the wing of the music this morning and enter your soul to give you a wonderful holiday season. So without any further ado, I'm going to introduce to you our accompanist, Michael DeStefano, who's going to come sing a beautiful anthem this morning. Thy way, not mine, O Lord, and I know that it's our heart's desire.
Thank you.
I enjoy just about every season of the year. But I will tell you that Christmas is my favorite time of year. I love just about everything there is to do with Christmas. I love all the stress. I love all the shopping. I love all the programs, and I love all the rehearsals. I'm every orchestra and choir's nightmare. I love it all. And I just love the wonderful season and the opportunity that we have to announce to the world that the Savior of the world has been born.
Praise God.
In fact, he lived a life on this earth, died for your sins, shed his blood, and went back to the throne of God to make intercession for all the boys and girls and all the men and women everywhere across the planet, that they might know Jesus and the power of his resurrection, to know what it is to have their sins forgiven and have peace in their heart. What a wonderful time of the year. And so I admonish you to just wake up every morning and say, let the stress begin. Happy Thanksgiving and Merry Christmas to all.
Thank you. Thank you. so much, Brother Shroud, and all the orchestra. Thank you so much. Give him another round of applause. Yeah. It's been nearly a year ago now. He called me up and said, I want your big group. Can they come and do a Christmas service for us? And so, like I said, it was nearly a year ago. We put a date on the schedule, and I called him up a few months ago, and we confirmed the date. And we're so glad to be here today and to be able to worship together with you and share in the seasons and the songs and most of all the presence of the Lord here today. Thank you for coming out. What a great looking crowd. I want to just share a few moments about what God is doing at our school there at Penn Bible Institute. Many of you I was able to meet as you came in today. For those of you that I have not yet met, my name is Kent Engel. I'm the Director of Public Relations there at Penn Bible Institute. And it excites me to be able to see what God is doing through our school. And of course, I'm a big believer in Christian education and the philosophy behind that, not only from our kindergarten all the way up through our high school seniors, but even into the college. And to know what God is doing in the lives of our young people in this generation and the potential that they have to change the world for Jesus Christ. There at Penn, our goal and our mission has always been to train young people for ministry. Ministry of all different kinds. Some of these young people will be pastors. Some of them may be missionaries or Christian school teachers. Obviously, all of the musicians using that gift and talent and ability that God has given them. Our goal is to send them out into the white harvest field. Jesus said in Matthew chapter 9 that we should pray the Lord of the harvest that he would send forth laborers into the harvest field. And I have a unique perspective there at Pennview. My office gets phone calls from various different harvest fields, pastors looking for musicians, or maybe a Christian school administrator looking for teachers. There's mission fields that need missionaries. There's churches that need pastors. There's a number of different open doors and opportunities and places for people to minister today. And as Jesus said, the harvest truly is plenteous, but the laborers are few. Pray ye therefore the Lord of the harvest that he would send forth laborers into his harvest field. And that's what we're doing. For over 45 years now, a little school 15 minutes away from here, but we're growing. God is helping us to send out laborers into the harvest field. And this year we were excited to see a significant increase in our college enrollment. And we feel like the future is so bright for us there at Penview Bible Institute as we continue to do what God has called us to do in sending out laborers into his harvest field. We partner together with the local church, with you. Thank you for your support of our school over the years. I know many people in this congregation have been friends of the school, and there's some alumni here. Thank you so much. And we want to continue to partner together with you. At the end of this service, there'll be actually just a few minutes. Pastor May is coming to lift a love offering for Penview Bible Institute. Over the years, we've continued to be a faith-based ministry. And that means we don't rely on any one particular church group or denomination or organization just to budget and underlay all of our expenses. But it says God lays it on the hearts of people just like you all across the United States and Canada to see the potential that these young people have and to come alongside of us and help us in fulfilling that mission of sending out laborers into the harvest field. Through your financial gifts, through your volunteer spirit, through all that you do for Penview, through your prayer support, that's how we're able to operate. Thank you for supporting us, for partnering together with us. Pastor May, thank you for letting us be here. God bless you.
Thank you. Actually, the plan just got changed, Kent. We're going to put the offering off till the very end. Lucas just asked me. The orchestra has several more songs prepared to do for you. You're not going to argue with that. Amen? Amen? Okay. I'm mesmerized sitting here, too. I mean, I'm just sitting here mesmerized by the gifts God has poured into the lives of these young people and their instructors, their director, Lucas, and the gifts of all the folks at Pennview. And I know that you're enjoying this. I am absolutely sure of that. But we're just going to keep rolling on. Lucas is going to go back up and direct the choir, and then we'll take the offering at the very end. Let's welcome the choir back with us, or the orchestra back with us. Thank you.
a moment. Really, the Hummel United Methodist Church gets to be a part of something this morning that is extra special to me. And let me just take a few of your moments of your time to explain why. This is my fifth year as the director of music at Penn View. And when I came to Penn View, I had 12 people in my orchestra. 12 people. And it was my dream that I would be able to establish an orchestra that would be able to play an entire concert by themselves. And so we began to pray and work that direction. Needless to say, about 34 people later, I walked onto the bus this morning with a big cheesy grin on my face, thinking about how good God has been to us. And so, I'm telling you what, people, it's only the Lord that can put this orchestra together, and with fluctuating students year by year, I'm just so happy with what God has done with the music program there at Penn View Bible Institute. And I just wanted him to know that all the glory goes to him. But it's kind of an extra special Sunday. And this is our first time that this orchestra has played an entire concert by themselves. We often travel with the choir, and they play a lot of music with the choir, but to play an entire service of nothing but, you know, they've kind of put their big boy pants on and they're doing it all by themselves. I'm so proud of them today. I'm so very proud of them today, and I want them to know how deeply how much I deeply appreciate their commitment, not only to their music, but to Jesus Christ, who is the author of music. And he is the beginning of every and anything good that will come out of their life. And that is our hope and our anticipation there at the school, to give them those values. We're going to play one more song for you this morning before they take the offering. And we want to invite you to our Christmas musical before Monique comes to sing for you. Our Christmas musical this year runs December 6th, December 7th, and December 8th. It's our first year to do three nights. The administrative committee told me that the only way that I would ever be able to do it three nights is if I filled up that large auditorium for two nights. So the choir and orchestra began to pray, and last year we had about 1,000 people Friday night, about 1,000 people on Saturday night. It was exciting. There's nothing like attending a concert when it is from front to back. And people, if you have not attended the Christmas musical, I'm only a very small part of what these young people do. It's amazing. There's drama, there's music, there's orchestra music, there's choir, there's children's choirs, and the music is absolutely breathtaking, and we share the Christmas story, and you need to come. December 6th, 7th, and 8th, I don't care if you come all three nights, bring your far-flung friends and family. We want you to come right there in Penn's Creek off of Raspberry Street. You don't want to miss it. It's the best thing happening right here in this area when it comes to Christmas music. Want to be there. These young people pour their heart and their soul out into this production, and you want to be there. Please put it in your date book, December 6th, 7th, and 8th. We want you all to come. It's a great, great time of Christmas celebration. Monique's going to come and sing a wonderful gospel song written by Donnie Rambo that says, "We shall behold him in all of his glory, face to face. And church, what we see through a glass darkly," as James tells us in the New Testament. He said, we can only see through a glass darkly, but one of these days, ladies and gentlemen, heaven won't be that cloudy thing that you see off in the distance, but it will be a reality for all of those who love his appearing. And this morning, as you sit here today, I want your heart to be lifted up to realms above. as you think about the fact that one day, if we'll stay faithful and true, we shall be home.
Thank you.
Going to ask our ushers to come forward. I'll have a word of prayer here. There won't be any doxology. You can just take the plates, keep them in the back after the offering is received. When you came in this morning, you received an envelope, not your ordinary Sunday morning envelope, and we invite you to give as the Spirit would lead you to give, and I pray that you will mark those dates down on your calendar for December. Karen and I just said we're going, so we'll be at Penn View. I hope many of you will go over to. I mean, it's all of 5 miles, right, to Penn's Creek, and enjoy a wonderful night celebrating our Savior's birth. I just wondered when I think about the orchestra and I look around and I see all the different parts of the orchestra, it just reminds me, and I'm sure it's not the first time it's been used as an example of the body of Christ and how it takes every one of us. I mean, imagine an orchestra without the percussion section. Imagine it without a director, of course, or the strings, or any of the parts of the orchestra, how that orchestra would not be able to function as it was intended. And the same is true for us. So I hope that that'll be an example for you too, that as we leave this place today, we'll remember we're part of the body of Christ, and He's given us a great responsibility and great gifts to use as you've witnessed here today. These folks don't just make music, they make music to the Lord, and there's a big difference in that. So praise the Lord for what you've witnessed today, for what you've experienced, and take that joy with you out into the Lord, out into the world. Ushers, come on forward. The folks are going to continue to pack up because they know we have a Sunday school class in here afterwards, and they are just awesome. I hope that you'll personally thank them on your way out for being here this morning. Let's bow our heads in prayer. God, you are great, and you have made us so rich, Lord, blessed us so greatly, and we thank you, Father, for once again being present with us here and present every moment of every day, being just what we need, just when we need you, Lord. And so we thank you and praise you, for great is your faithfulness. You abound in love and show us mercies every morning, Lord. So we just lift up our praise to you this day, give you thanks for this wonderful orchestra, for Lucas and for Kent and for all the work of all these young people, sharing the good news of Jesus Christ through the gift of their music. And we just pray your great, great blessings upon them, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. And everyone said, amen. And amen. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thanks, Kevin. Amen. God bless you in your going today. Let's lift it up. These folks can still hear your applause. Let's give them thanks. I hope you'll head off to Sunday school and enjoy another great hour of God's presence.